皆さん、こんにちは。シンプソンです。
皆さん、こんにちは。ひよりです。
Today we're going to have a look at prepositions. Being able to say specifically where someone or something is. So it's in answer to the questions like, where is the pen?
ペンはどこにありますか？
Or where is the dog?
犬はどこにいますか？
And straight away, please remember that あります is for objects. Whereas imas is for people and animals. So in Japanese, to specify where something or someone is, the sentence structure is one of these two options, depending on what you want to emphasize. So it could be place ni, person or object ga imas or arimas, or it might be person or object wa place ni. Imas or arimas. It just depends on what you want to emphasize. In English, we do the same thing. So, for example, using the first type of sentence, my mum is in the living room.
今にお母さんがいます。
And so, technically, if we wanted to split hairs, the real translation for that would be in the living room, there is my mum. But in English, we just say my mum is in the living room. An example of the second way of expressing prepositions and locating things is this second example sentence. The TV is in the living room.
テレビは今にあります。
They're both perfectly correct. They just slightly alter the emphasis, so it's up to you how you want to express yourself. That's for locating things, generally speaking, inside a room, inside a house, somewhere sort of generally speaking. If we want to specify where something or someone is, specifically in relation to where something else or someone else is, we need to learn some prepositions. So, on top of, on or above is,
上、
underneath or below is,
下、
Inside, in the middle of, or in is
中、
behind, or to the back of is
後ろ、
in front of is
前、
next to or beside,
隣、
left to the left of,
左、
to the right of,
右、
close to or next to,
そば、
nearby,
近く、
next to or to the side of,
横、
and lastly outside.
外。
So, using these prepositions in full sentences, the sentence structure is largely unchanged from before. We're just putting in the prepositions now. Let's have a look. Again, we've got two options. They both end up meaning the same thing. You're just altering the emphasis slightly. So, place, no, location, ni, person or object, ga, imas or arimas. So that location is referring to these prepositions we're talking about. So, ue, shita, naka. Or you can express yourself person slash object wa, place no location or preposition ni imas or arimas. Remember, use arimasen to say something isn't there, and imasen to say someone isn't there. For example, there is a cat. Under the kotatsu.
こたつの下に猫がいます。
So that's an example of how we can use the first sentence structure. This second example, using the second sentence structure, ends up meaning the same thing. We're just changing the emphasis. The oranges are on the kotatsu.
オレンジはこたつの上にあります。
Now, this change in emphasis I'm talking about. The first example, if you wanted to get technical, the translation would be under the kotatsu there is a cat. Whereas the second example would be the oranges are on the kotatsu. It's just specifying, it's just playing around with the emphasis. じゃあ、またね。
またね。